everybody left to sing, and we're gonna have a good time tonight. We do have. We do have cake and ice cream tonight. There's several birthdays. Miss Jeannie back there, her birthday is today. Brandon's birthday is Tuesday. Hers is the 4th of August. Joyce, cuz yours was yesterday?
No.
Oh, Jake Gale, okay. 35, all right. We got several birthdays, so we're celebrating all y'all's birthdays for this month, whoever they were. We've got cake and ice cream over there ready. And so all that's between that cake and ice cream and y'all is the singing. So let's get on with it. Let's pray. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this day you've given us. God, I thank you for your word and how powerful it is, God. God, as it speaks to our hearts, God, let us listen to it, hide it in our hearts, God, that we might be able to stand in that day against the wiles of the devil, God, as we fight him. You know, God, we can't fight him on our own strength, but God, we can fight him with your word. And, God, your word is hid in our heart tonight. And Lord, I thank you for that. I thank you for your power and your presence in our lives. God, how you take our lives, as filthy and dirty and muddy as our lives are, God, you clean us up. God, you take us where we need to go. You give us what we need to do. Father, thank you for moving us in that direction. I thank God tonight, Lord, that I'm not where I used to be. I'm not where I need to be, God. I'm not still. God, you clean me up. Thank you, God, for your salvation tonight, bringing me through that mess. And Lord, tonight, we just want to worship you in spirit and truth. God, pour your spirit out on this place tonight. Let us know and say when we leave this place tonight. God, it's been good to be in your house. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good evening, church.
Good evening.
Good to see all of you. We didn't have just a whole lot to sign up for singing tonight, so what we've done is we just threw all y'all's name in a hat. Whoever we draw out is going to have to sing. Is that fair enough?
They're all
All right, we're going to start out with a couple of Christmas songs tonight. Get things rolling and then we'll take over and see what happens. All right.
I
feel my whole cup about to break. I will cling to your unchanging grace. Let the waters come and the earth give way. I'll be dancing in the rain. I feel you on the rock. That's a solid rock I stand on. On Christ's solid rock, I stand on the ground, you see, he stands so strong, your feet and clap your hands, our feet are on the rock. On Christ's solid rock, I stand on the ground, you see, he stands so strong, your feet and clap your hands, our feet are on the rock. May I feel my hope about to break. I will cling to your unchanging grace. Let the waters come and the earth give way. I'll be dancing in the rain. May I feel my hope about to break. I will cling to your unchanging grace. Let the waters come and the earth give way. I'll be dancing in the rain.
Where's that place at that you go? Where are you going to speak at? Where's it at? Is it?
Oh, Fire! with all my Jesus. He makes the way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can't save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. And the good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. And let my Jesus change.
Thank you. Hi. It took me a few minutes to get up here, right? I wrote some poems. Most of you guys have heard some of them, but I'm going to read a couple of them. This one is called Come, and it's from, I got it from Psalms 116, 1 through 2. I love the Lord, for He heard my voice. He heard my cry for mercy. Because He turned His ear to me, I will call on Him as long as I live. Come. When I cried out to the Lord, He heard me. He heard my innermost anguish cry from the depth of my soul. Please forgive me, my Lord. My sin has consumed me. My mind preoccupies my sin. It plays it over and over, again like a movie screen. But my Lord sits on the throne above the shining stars, and He's not high and mighty not to hear my desperate cry. I'm guilty and remorseful. He bends down His head next to mine and hears Him say, "Forgive me, Lord, for all my sins. I believe You, Jesus. You died on the cross for me. On the third day, You rose from the grave. You're alive and living in my heart today. Come, it's not too late to have a little talk with Jesus. Come." The next verse for this next poem is from Romans 10:11. As Scripture says, anyone who believes in Him will never be put to shame. Believe. Hey, because I believed Jesus is Lord and died on the cross. The third day, You, God, rose Jesus from the dead. I can say good morning, Lord. I feel Your love. Surround me on this beautiful day. You thought of me before I was even conceived. You took time to consider who I'd be in this 21st century. Wow. I'm Your masterpiece, made by Your hands, like Adam and Eve. You gave me gifts, talents, passions, purpose. That's all from You. Lord, how can I make a difference in this evil world? With distractions all around me, I'm very much human, flawed, and weak. I make a great number of mistakes throughout the day. How in the world can You use me? I'm only a speck on this earth from outer space. The Lord whispers in my heart's door with His soft, gentle voice. Tell others about me. Shine like grams of stars in the night sky. Shine like never before, because I'm coming as a thief in the night to gather my chosen ones that believe in my Son Jesus.
I'm a youth. We had church camp. Y'all didn't hear much about church camp because this year's church camp was more of a personal thing for them, but we studied about forgiveness, forgetting things that you cannot forget. And that's hard for all of us, even as adults. But, you know, we learned some songs, and Abby unfortunately didn't get to join us, but I heard she knows this song. But we're going to introduce you to some songs, and hopefully we can use them going forward for congregation songs. Yeah, I'm going to make them eat that. I'm going to come back, and they're going to eat microphones. But we're going to sing I See Grace.
Shame, the kind that comes from mistakes, the kind that won't go away. When I turn around, they were right there to remind me. I've seen regret, the kind that messes with your head, the failures that you can't forget. But standing here now, I'm thinking God is behind me, cause I've seen nail scars and wipe it all away. Now I see grace. Hallelujah, I stand in faith. I'm staring at an empty grave, and it's lonely to hold.
When I let you down, you know.
senses, the things I could not understand. Many times in trials, weakness blurs my vision, and my frustration gets so out of hand. Instead, I am reminded I've never been forsaken. Never had to stand one test alone. And as I look at all the victories, the spirit rises up in me. It's through the fire, my weakness is made strong. He never promised that the cross would not get heavy, and the hill would not
the battle. You see my victory. When all I see is the mountain, you see a mountain move. And as I walk through the shadows, your love surrounds me. There's nothing to fear now, for
I go to verse 36, and I will take a look again at the place where Jesus went on his last night with his disciples. He went into the Garden of Gethsemane. He told James and John, y'all stay here and pray. He said, I've got to go over here, and I've got to talk to my dad. And he went alone over there in the Garden of Gethsemane and got down on his knees, him and the Father and the Holy Ghost. They had a meeting over there in the Garden of Gethsemane. And in that meeting, Jesus looked down in the cup that he was going to have to drink. And I'm here to tell you tonight what he saw in that cup. He saw your sin. He saw my sin. He saw the sin of every sinner that's ever been born. He looked into that cup and he said, nevertheless, Father, I'll drink from that cup because I know that they can be saved. I know that you love them. I'm not going to give up on them now.
Jesus saved. He saved every person that calls on the name of Jesus. There ain't nobody like my Jesus tonight.
He's better than that ice cream. Yeah. That ice cream will satisfy you for a little while. But my Jesus, when he comes into your life, he will change your life forever. Oh, I wish I had time to preach tonight. Listen, he left that garden that morning, led away, being betrayed by Judas himself. He cut off, Peter cut off that Malchus's ear, and Jesus reached down in the Garden of Gethsemane and picked up that bloody ear and put it back on that old Roman soldier. And that old Roman soldier, I guarantee you tonight, his life never was the same. He witnessed the greatest miracle that he had ever seen. And that same man that looked in the cup, that same man that put his ear back on, went to the cross of Golgotha's hill and gave his life for that man. Just like he did with me. Oh, I thank God tonight that I serve a risen Savior. He's alive today, folks. He ain't dead. And he ain't give up on you. He's still working on me and you. Come on, Greg, let's sing.
Hey, Nate, I have a question.
Yeah.
I ain't preaching tonight. But if I was.
Come on, bro.
I talked about that fourth man in the fire.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Whenever they looked over, they said, who is that man? And boys down there rejoicing in that fire. So you're going through a fire with the fourth man there. But I'm not preaching tonight. But I would like to request something if you could. I know you love the pastor, I've been through the shoes that he's in, different situations, but I know he's tired. And I know that he's weary. And you really don't realize the unseen battles that this man and his wife go through as a pastor. He loves y'all very much. But I'm telling you, it is a constant battle. It don't quit when you walk through the door. It gets worse.
Yeah.
For him. And then he just think about this, what this man went through. He lost his bridge in the tornado. And the church and the flood that y'all all know. But God is constant. And I would like, I have no authority or nothing in this church, but I would like tonight. I just tell God to lead you. Y'all don't want to, you ain't got to. But I'd like to, for us to take a couple of chairs right over there. And let Nick, Brother Nick, Pastor Nick, whatever you call him. Come cuz. If you let him and his wife sit in two chairs, and y'all, us surrounding him, and have a prayer for him and his wife. If you don't want to, we got to.
Yeah.
But I just feel Lord need that we pray for this precious couple that is the tip of the sword for this church.
Yeah.
He hits the battles first, like that old tip does. And when he pierces him, it hits like the shield that they have. So I don't want to interrupt anything or stop anything, but it's just on my heart to share that with y'all. And also something different that y'all may not have ever done before. I know Nick has. I like to share this. My first surrender to preach. Y'all have no idea about this. But it's only after a few years we've been eating together. And I knew Nick was a man of God, respected. I didn't know nothing. I was just in there and trying to read and study. And my cousin, we was having ice cream that night in the sanctuary, in the Family Life Center. And I was talking to somebody, and I looked up, and Brother Nick came down and sat beside me. I swear, as I'm standing here, I was like, oh, no. He's going to talk about something in the Bible, and I ain't going to nobody. And so I was scared. I was intimidated. But this man sat down and talked and encouraged me, and I felt better. You probably don't even remember. And, but I tell you, I know he's a man of God. This is well again. So if we can, I don't know if we can have an invitational song. I don't know how y'all want to do this. I mean, you can go ahead and have an invitational song, or we can surround them right now. Songs play. But as I was saying, let's do something a little different. I've done on this when I was at the end of the time or two. But when we pray tonight for them, I want all of us to pray out loud. Have y'all ever done that before? I'll tell you something powerful. Don't listen to the person next to you. You speak from your heart to God. And if you say it out loud, I'm telling you, it'll make goosebumps come on the back of your neck. When you see a crowd of people crying out to God with their heart for a dear brother. So I'd like to do that tonight if it's made. If you want to play a song while we surround them and pray, or if you want to do an invitation song, whatever you want to do, let's do it right now. Get your wife.
I'm going to get right here in a minute. I'll get my wife out here.
Get you.
Trying to take over, this is coming from God. God hit my heart with this, and I really want y'all to experience this with me. When you pray out loud to God. Cry out loud, and don't listen to find this person next to you. And I'm telling you, and once we pray for a little bit, and I feel the sense, I'll end this in prayer, if that's okay. All right. Let's start right now, Father.
Lord, I just pray that your mighty men would move upon them and their family. No doubt, Lord, there's circumstances in their lives, Father, that, Lord, needs your attention. Lord, no doubt, there's brokenness in his family, Father. Lord, I just ask that you would move on his behalf, Father. Lord, we love him and we thank you for him. We praise you, Father, for putting him in our life, Father. For what you've used him in my life, Father. I just thank you and praise you. Lord, I just lift him up to you, Father. Lord, I just pray, Lord, that you would anoint him, Father, from his toes to the top of his head, Father. Lord, that you would move on his behalf, Father. Lord, in this destruction here, Father. Lord, as he tries to leave, Father. Lord, help him, Father. Lord, open doors that only you can open, Father. Lord, shut doors that only you can shut, Father. Lord, draw in those that needs to know you, Father. Lord, send them here, Father. Lord, let them see that light upon a hill shining bright, Father. Lord, use us, Father, Lord, to speak to them. Fill us with your Spirit, Father. Lord, move on our behalf, Father. Lord, we'll be found always, Father. We're giving you all the praise.
Dear Father, I come to you tonight. And dear God, I pray for this precious couple. God, I pray you link their shields together, just as they armor did. God, I believe you're the same God today that anointed them men years ago to pin down the holy word that rolled right out of your mouth. God, I believe that you're the same today that he was yesterday. And God, I pray right now that we, our hearts, that we remember today that God, you're still alive. That God, you're still powerful. That God, you still do things that man can't do. And God, right now, I'm going to just surrender my heart to you. That God, I pray, God, if you want to use this old vessel, that God, you use me. God, I'm yours. God, I know I've messed up. But God, I know you forgave me. And God, I thank you for this congregation of people. God, I pray you anoint them, you bless them. And God, may this church be a shining beacon light, God, in this community. That God, you take this old blood that you flood that's got a publicity on TV. That people know about Pryor's work in the Independent Baptist Church now. And God, that was your plan. And God, people know about this little old country church. And God, may the power of God, when they open the door, hit them right in the heart. And God, we give you all the honor, the praise, and glory. And God, we want to thank you for ice cream.
God, we want to thank you for the change.
Thank
you. But most of all, we want to thank you for knowing you're right here with us. In Christ's name.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
You'll go with me.
Yeah.
Let's get out.